I am the assistant choreographer for Tarzan.
I'm Casey, and I am the assistant music director and assistant makeup.
Okay, great. My name is Marcia Marra, and I've been doing makeup for SLOC for years, like 28 years.
So what was your first production with SLOC?
My first production was Meet Me in St. Louis with SLOC. And it was only the third production I'd ever done makeup on totally. It was wonderful. It was a wonderful production. It was very old fashioned and has good songs. So, yeah.
Yeah, that was perfect.
Do you have any like favorite memories from
that production?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. The thing I remember the most about Meet Me in St. Louis were the costumes. The woman who costumed it, I didn't do anything with her after that. I don't even know if she was around after that, but she owned an antique store, and she used actually authentic antique costumes in that production. They were all fragile. We were really worried they were gonna, you know, rip, but they were beautiful costumes, and that's the one thing that sticks out from that. And it was also just meeting all new people, you know. It was like a big thing for me. I was brought over here by another makeup person who was working in Gilderland, and I did two shows over there, Annie and Oliver, and all I did for those shows for makeup, the makeup person would only let me put dirt on the kids. So all I did was dirt the kids up in both shows. That's it. But then when I came over here, that was my really first one.
So over the decades that you've been here, how has SLOC changed? And like, what's the same and what's grown and like continues to grow and change?
Oh, lots has changed. Well, we moved buildings for one. When I first started, we were at the other building, which was up on Central Avenue, the end of Central Avenue. I'm not sure if it's Central Avenue there. Anyway, it was in a different section, which was a little bit dicey. We used to get our cars broken into, and it was not a good area. And I don't remember when, we could check the date, they moved down here. But I also co-produced and worked on the first show down here, which was Drowsy Chaperone. And it was like a breath of fresh air coming down here. Everything was new, and they had just done the whole theater over. And but while we were getting through and rehearsing that show, there was carpenters. It was really a challenge because they were, you know, doing everything in the theater, and we were trying to do our show too. So that's. That's one change, big change, was built just the facility. Plus, the other part of it that's changed is the addition of you guys, which is great because we didn't have any youth productions that I know of back then over there at the other store. And then when we came down here, is when we added the youth productions. And that's a huge change, which is for the better. You know, you guys got to come in and we got to experience your shows. We did 13, but that was from here too, I believe. That was the first one I worked on.
What has your involvement been like over the years?
Mainly at SLOC, it's been makeup and nothing but makeup. I don't even do hair. Unfortunately, I'm not really good at hair. I mean, I could fix a little hair there and here, but don't ask me to design hair because I'm not. Yeah, that's been my main involvement, is makeup. For many shows, many. I was going around looking at all the pictures here, and there's a lot that good memories, you know.
What other places have you worked at?
Oh, wow, there's a lot. Well, right now in rehearsal for Not So Common Players Little Shop, which is going to go off next weekend. Back in the day, I did Family Players, is where Annie and Oliver were the first. That's Gilderland. I did Bethlehem Town Players. I did the Hilltown Players, which was up in Burnox and Westerlo. That was an interesting group because what they would do is go from church to church and set up their set and their everything. They set it up, do the show, and take it down every day. every time. It was like a big deal. It was like a roving thing. That was interesting. Not So Common Players is where I am now. Where else did I go? Oh, I'm trying to, I don't know. I can't, let me think. Oh, Classic Theater Guild. And we did things at, over by Proctor's. And there's a little theater next to Proctor's that I don't think anybody knows about. And it's up upstairs. We did that. I did Confetti Stage. I'll stop. That's those are the ones I can think of now. There's probably a couple more, and I feel I might have missed them, but anyway.
Do you have, like, a favorite production that you did, like, what's your favorite look from a production that you've done?
Yeah, one of my favorites was one that was really challenging. That's why I liked it. What's the show with the twins in the circus?
Sideshow.
Thanks, Christine. So one of my favorites was, because it was challenging, was Sideshow, because in that show, first of all, you have conjoined twins that are two different people that kind of have to look alike, but there were a lot of different Sideshow characters. There was a guy who was a snake lizard guy, and I made him all like scaly, I had like this stencil and made lizard scales all over him. There were just a lot of Sideshow characters that were fun, you know, half man, half woman person. So that was kind of one of my favorites. There are a lot of other favorites that just, yeah. Every show is, I shouldn't say that, but it's true. Almost every show is my favorite. I didn't have any bad experiences, not one. So it's good to get into theater.
Do you have any words of wisdom for our youth performers and our youth, like, production staff?
I think the most important thing that, and I think you guys probably already know this, is you're in the show to do what the director says, and you can bring your character to it and your thoughts to it, but it's the director's call. So you always have to know that they know what they're doing, and you might not even know what they're doing when they're setting it up and you're doing it. But in the end, it will be a good production because they see the whole picture. I think, you know what I'm saying? It's like, yeah, always trust everybody who's working with you, because they kind of know the big picture, and you might not see it. And even the makeup person, you might think it's the worst. Oh, you know, I don't look good. You can offer your suggestions to people if you think something would look better, because we always like to hear it. But you should always trust, them all the way. And the best actors I've ever worked with, SLOC, everywhere else, have always, you know, done whatever's been said to do, and it's great, you know. So that's it.
Great.
All right. Awesome. Is that it?
Yeah. That was awesome. You nailed it, Marcia. You nailed it.
Was I too tall?